English.
That's just the trouble. It may be the climate, the fog and the damp, the high cost of living, the news. But you'll notice an odd sort of rigour or cramp whenever an Englishman woos. Though passion abroad may be hot, in England, quite frankly, they're not. The French never blench or retrench on a bench in a park with the moon up above. But there's nothing so dumb or so glum or so rum as an Englishman in love. The Swiss never miss or the bliss of a kiss, for romance fits the Swiss like a glove. But there's nothing so grim or so prim or so dim as an Englishman in love. The Greeks and the Sikhs are impassioned, and so are the Laps and the Czechs. But there's nothing so heavily rationed as Anglo-Saxon sex. The Danes are at pains to be amorous swains. The Bolivians can't get enough. But there's nothing so lame or so tame with a dame as an Englishman in love. The Finns think of twins when the winter begins. The Armenians, heavens above!
But there's nothing so slack as the lack of attack in an Englishman in love.
The Dutch have a clutch with a much surer touch. Neapolitans cool like a dove.
But there's nothing so weak or so bleak or so meek as an Englishman in love.
The Turks shoot the works and are willing. The Arabs throw open their tents.
But there's nothing so distantly chilling as fine young English gents.
The Swedes so unreads have got all that it needs, while the Bulgar gets vulgarly rough.
But there's nothing so quaint or so faint with restraint as an Englishman in love.
Burmese, if you please, have the notion that falling in love can be fun.
But the Englishman shows no emotion. It simply is a don.
The Moor, to be sure, isn't poor at Le Mor. When he presses his suit, it's a shove.
But there's nothing so trite or so rightly polite as an Englishman in love.
If he talks about dogs, nuclear fission, or fogs, that's an Englishman in love.